Welcome to Math Advice. In this video, let me discuss restriction on assignments as a special case of assignment problem. That is, if there is some restrictions on assigning a particular job to a particular machine, then such type of problems also can solve by make use of Hungarian assignment algorithm. That is, sometimes due to technical space or some other restriction do not permit the assignment of particular job to a particular facility. Such type of problem can also be easily solved by assigning a very heavy cost. Here we have to take the very heavy cost either as m or infinity to the corresponding cell. And such type of job will then be automatically excluded while making the final assignment. By doing so, we have to proceed as usual in case of balanced assignment problem. The remaining process is same. After this, the remaining process is same as we do in case of balanced assignment problem. Let me now move on to an example. A plant layout needs modification. A manager decides to install 4 new machines, 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 5 vacant locations available on the shop floor, that is A, B, C, D, E. Because of limited space, machine 2 cannot be installed at location C, and machine 3 cannot be installed at location A. And the cost of placing of machines at locations are given in terms of rupees as a cost matrix here. Then here we have to find out the optimum assignment schedules. Here we have 2 restrictions. Machine 2 cannot be installed at location C. So this we can't place machine 2 in location C. And also we can't install machine 3 in location A. So these 2 are the restrictions. So how to avoid these restrictions in our calculation is, we have to take a very heavy cost, infinity, at these cells, and we have to proceed as usual. And you know already, when we multiply infinity with any number, you get the value infinity. When you add any value with infinity, that is infinity itself. And also when you subtract any value from infinity, you get infinity itself. So the value doesn't change, whatever may be the addition process or subtraction process we have carried out when we are discussing the Hungarian algorithm. Okay? Now, this is for the given matrix. Look at the matrix. It has 4 rows and 5 columns. It is a 4x4 matrix. So to make it as a balanced one, I have to introduce one more dummy row, because we have only four rows but we have 5 columns. So we introduce a dummy row. I name that as a row number 5 with 0 cost elements. After introducing the dummy row, the matrix now becomes balanced assignment problem. And also it is given that there are 2 restrictions in this cell are also at this cell. So here we have to assign a heavy cost infinity. So after introducing a heavy cost infinity and also a dummy row, now the matrix is a balanced one. Then we make use of, and also the objective of this cost matrix of minimization. So objective of this cost matrix is minimization, and it is a balanced one. So if so, we make use of Hungarian assignment algorithm to proceed further to obtain the optimum assignment schedule and its associated cost. Now let me move on to step 1. What we are going to do in step 1 is, in this balanced matrix, look at in each row has at least 1 zero element or not. We have to check here whether each row has at least 1 zero element or not. Look at the first row, doesn't have any zero element. Second row, third row, and fourth row also. Fifth row has zero element, so leave this. So if it doesn't have any zero elements, what we do, we just pick out the minimum element in each row and subtract it from its corresponding row entries. So the first row has a minimum element is 19 is the minimum element. The second row, the minimum element is, again here itself 19. Third row has the minimum element 17, and the fourth row has the minimum element 17. Last row has already zero elements, so leave this last row. So we have to write down now row minima, that is minimum element of each row, that is 19, 19, 17, 17, last row. No need to write down the minimum element since it already has zero elements. Now we have to subtract these minimum elements, that is we have to subtract this row minima from its corresponding row entries now. So let me start with the first row. 19 minus 19, 0. 21 minus 19, 2. 25 minus 19, 6. 20 minus 19, 1. 21 minus 19, 2. Let's move on to second row. Second row also has a minimum element 19. So let me subtract from its second row entries. So 22 minus 19, 3. 19 minus 19, 0. So as I told you already, when you add or subtract any value to infinity, the value doesn't change. So infinity minus 19 is infinity itself. Next. 20 minus 19, 1. 19 minus 19, 0. Let's third row, infinity minus 17, value doesn't change, so we have infinity itself. 21 minus 17, that is 4. 24 minus 17, 7. 21 minus 17, 4. 17 minus 17, 0. Next, for the fourth row, we have to subtract 17 from fourth row elements. So 24 minus 17, 7. 18 minus 17, 1. 22 minus 17, 5. 17 minus 17, 0. 18 minus 17, 1. And we write down the last row elements as it is. Now, after subtracting minimum elements from each row to get at least one zero element in each row, let us now verify along column wise too. Look at the first, second and third, fourth column. So all of them having at least one zero element, so which means now the matrix is ready for making assignment. As usual, let me now first write down the number of zeros in each row outside of the matrix. So first row has only one zero, second row has two zeros, third row has one zero, fourth row has one zero, and the fifth row has five zeros. So no need to write down the number of zeros outside of the matrix like this. You just keep that in mind, and always we give the assignment for the matrix which is less number of zeros compared with other rows. Okay. So now let me start with either first row, third row or fourth row. Now let me start with the first row. I am going to make assignment at this position. After making assignment, class the remaining zeros in the same column and row ways. So row ways it doesn't have any zero, column ways it has zero element, so I class the zero element. So the number of zero here become 4. Next, let me move on to the third row since it has only one zero element. So here I am going to make an assignment. After making assignment, class the remaining zero elements in the same column and also row ways too. So row wise it doesn't have any zero element. So column wise it has zero elements here and here. So I cross off the zero elements like this. Now the second row now has only one zero element, whereas the last row has now three zero elements. Next, let's move on to either the second row or fourth row here. Since both of them having only one zeros, so arbitrarily I have to take the second row. So I make an assignment at this position. After making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same row and column base. Next. So the last row now has two zero elements, whereas the fourth row has only one zero element. So So I'm going to make a cement at this position. So after making a cement, cross the remaining zero elements in the same column and row wise. So column wise it has only one zero element. I have crossed the element like this. So let us come to the last row. It has only one zero element at this position. So I'm going to make a cement at this position. After making a cement, there is no zeros in the same row and column. So like this. Now, after making a cement, check whether each row has exactly one assignment. First row has an assignment at this position. Second row has an assignment at this position. Third row has an assignment at this position. And fourth row has an assignment at this position. And fifth row has an assignment at this position. Which means the current assignment schedule is optimal. Column wise, you have to check whether first column has an assignment, second column has an assignment, whereas the third, fourth, fifth column has an assignment. So we have obtained the optimum assignment schedule. So let me show this matrix clearly to you now. So this was the matrix we have arrived, and this is the corresponding assignment schedule. So the optimum assignment schedule is: machine 1 is installed at location A, and machine 2 is installed at location B, and machine 3 is installed at location E, and machine 4 is installed at location D, and 5 is installed at location C. So after finding the optimum assignment schedule, next we have to calculate the minimum cost associated with these positions. So this is not the original cost associated with this position. So we have to know what is the original cost associated with this position. For that, let's now move on to the given matrix and look at the cost associated with these positions. So this was the given matrix. So in this given matrix 1 to A, the cost associated with 1 to A is 19, 2 to B, that is again 19, 3 to E, that is 17, and 4 to D, that is 17, and 5 to C. Actually, the given problem is unbalanced, so to make it balanced, we introduce a dummy row with zero cost. So at this position, we have zero. So 5 to C, we have zero. So by adding all these values, we get the cost associated with this position, that is minimum cost. That is 19 plus 17 plus 17 plus 0. So now adding all these values, we get 72. So for the given problem, the optimum assignment schedule is 1 to A, 2 to B, 3 to E, 4 to D, and 5 to C. And the minimum cost is rupees 72. So what is the conclusion based on this is, here look at 5 to C. Here 5 to C means a dummy machine is installed at location C. A dummy machine is installed at location C. Since we are giving only 4 machines, whereas 5 locations are available, so one of them is left without any assignment. That is, one of the locations is left without assignment. So the dummy machine is installed at location C, which means location C is left without any assignment of machine. Hope you got a clear idea about how to solve if there is a restrictions on assignment using Hungarian assignment algorithm. Thanks for watching. See you again in my next video.